So I'm back at Mom's house with Mallory, and Grandma's here. It's a week before my 40th birthday, so we thought we'd come back because next weekend is a friend's wedding, so I won't be here to celebrate. So we're going out to dinner tonight. And I was looking through some old boxes that I still have here from like two decades ago. And I saw my old 1997, my running log from that year. I've got a bunch of them, but I thought we'd flip through. I like these old things. Oh, Nathaniel's cell phone. Nathaniel, you see that? He had been one of the first people to get a cell phone. It was one of those big bricks that you have in the car. And, he worked at Walmart selling phones there. And so he had one of the first ones, and so that's what I have. Nathaniel's cell phone. He doesn't have the same number. Well, at least I don't think. But let's see. So this would have been when the winter of college. So went to Ryan's, that would be Ryan Hill, and ran 8 miles with him. We ran about 6:30 pace or under, which is good for these days. Because, you know, January 1st in Wisconsin is ice and snow and freezing cold. So, you know, sometimes you're not running your best on those days. But the point is just to get the mileage in. And then when you can start doing track work when spring comes, that's when you sharpen your speed. But if you get that base in you, the mileage, it's good. January 2nd, ran out past Conway's and back. Dan Conway is our coach. And he's one of the most famous coaches in Wisconsin history. It's really fortunate to have him, really fortunate to have Coach Knickerbocker. Okay, I said, I'm starting to see how great it is to do mileage that is progressive. I run and feel great every day and have great workouts. So it's nice to see these running logs because in business, it's obviously important to track results. Sometimes money is the benchmark, but there's a lot of other things to measure as well if you're serious about it. Sometimes if you don't spend time measuring, you don't sort of have that next step, next goals in mind. And so running taught me a lot about discipline and putting in hard work, tracking your progress. Okay, January 3rd, 4 mile warm up. 4 mile warm up. That sounds funny now. Like 4 miles would be like a run for me. 5 times the city hill was all snowy, so didn't get much of a workout. I only got 8.5 miles in that day. Not a big workout. Okay, January 4th, ran easy 6:40 per mile pace, was really slushy and slippery. Sunday, January 5th, was 8 degrees and way colder with the wind chill. Chad and I ran it in about, we ran 15 miles around the lake in an hour and 43 minutes, so just kind of jogging. 66.5 miles that week, 60 miles the next week. So I was doing some mileage, but not a lot at this point. On Monday, did 12 miles, and Tuesday, 12.5, 12, 12, then 3. Oh, that's right, I had to run in the basement of the school. On Thursday, ran 6 miles on Coach Conway's treadmill in the morning, and then I went down to Kenosha for the first day back from Christmas break, and then ran 6 miles there. So that was 12 that day. On Sunday, I had a 16-mile easy day. Huh. I like all these. Man, it brings back a lot of memories that I hadn't remembered. Oh, I had a good 3,000 meter race on Saturday. Oh, that's why I did 3 miles on the Friday. You know, you take it easy the night before. I even wrote comments on Sunday. I ran 16 miles after the race day. And I wrote, had to poop during the run. I went into the woods. Kind of gross, I know, but any long distance runner understands what I'm saying. 50 miles, 60 miles this week. The Lewis Invite, I ran a 425 mile, so I was just starting to get in a little bit of shape. Obviously, a 425 is 6 seconds slower than my high school time. So, but in the winter, you're just kind of trying to progressively get in shape because, in, you know, if I lived in California, you could be in good shape all year round. You still can in Wisconsin. It's just, it does take a little more tact because it's so cold and icy and, you know, it can tend to lead to slower, running slower, because that's all you can do. 63 and a half, 80 and a half this week. On February, 61 and a half. Man, I like this. Ran with Tony Myers that day. It's bringing back such good memory, such great friends. 6x400 meters in 63 to 66 seconds. Then 5x400 meters in 63 to 65 seconds. Then 10x100 meter sprints. Hamstrings were so sore, toughed it out and ran all right. Yeah, that seems... And then on Tuesday, I said was tired again today, but still ran fast. And then Wednesday, ran okay today. My legs are still worn out, but should be fine next Saturday. And let's see Saturday. Oh, I didn't... Oh, Saturday, I see. 1,500 meters, I placed third. And it was at the Oshkosh Invite, 4 minutes, 5 seconds. So like a 421 mile, so I still wasn't in good shape. Huh. Then down in Ames, Iowa, Friday I ran the mile in 4 minutes 19 seconds. Placed 4th in my heat. It says I wasn't breathing hard at all, but legs wouldn't push me in the critical last lap. I was probably wearing myself out a bit. I tended to do that. I thought more was better, so I'd run faster. And then I would do like 10-mile cooldowns after a race, which is ridiculous. Okay, here we go. This one was Sunday, 10 miles, 10 and a half miles in 62 minutes, 40 seconds, so 5:58 per mile. Then 10 times 40 meter hills, then 2 times 220 meter strides. That doesn't even make any sense to do. It doesn't... It's just a waste of energy. Now, I mean, not all of it, but that's not the smartest workout a person could be doing. But now I'm doing 30-mile weeks because obviously my body was starting to take its toll and broke down a bit. So I had to use the VersaClimber, the Nordic Track, ran in the pool. Huh. Yeah, but this is good. I like seeing this, though. Couldn't run. Now, March 18th, couldn't run because of sharp pains in my shin. I think I pulled the tissues that connect to the back of my shin. So the soleus muscle is what ended up being terrible. And then you'll see, biked. 11 miles that week. Then 13 miles the next week. I tried to go... So I did 8x400 meters in 61 to 62 seconds, last one in 59 seconds, then 10x110 meter sprints all out. I thought that was a good idea when I'd already torn my soleus muscle, and then biked, day off because of Easter, but I didn't take day offs for Easter, I just couldn't run, it says. Then, I was so stupid with those things. Then all VersaClimber, pool, bike, then again, 12x1 minutes, 8x1 minute, 10x20 second. And then bike. So apparently I would try coming back and do the hardest workouts. Nothing. So I remember being injured during that time. So stupid. So if you can progressively build up, people see all the way into May. Isn't that crazy? And then I was starting to come back. 8 miles at 6 minute per mile pace. 6 miles at comfortably hard 5:50 per mile pace. So, I mean, I was coming back a little bit, but then again, day after heel muscles, biked an hour and a half because I was coming back a little too strong. Yeah, but that's interesting. You know, I know we all say this, if we knew then what we know now, right? I don't have the talent now. My body wouldn't be able to push itself quite this hard. But I know what I would do. I'd be a lot smarter, right? And so, sometimes you shake your head and think, I could have done a lot more. But I did a lot in the running world. I did well. Then I found this again. I've posted this, you know, quite a few times. But this is Chad on the cover of Wired magazine, building the ultimate runner when he was running for Nike. So it's one of my favorite covers of all magazines, and not just because Chad's on it. And so, obviously, we had a good little Chautauqua group for a tiny little town, and then, you know, it's just fascinating that so many good runners came out of there. And that's a testament to Coach Conway and Coach Knickerbocker. But I'm going to get ready, because Ma's like, you better get ready. We got to be ready for dinner at 3. So I'm going to close this up.